Well, here we are in northwest Idaho, sometimes called the Panhandle, and we've got some truly awesome hunting ahead of us. Today, we're starting off by going after the one and only Rocky Mountain elk. Now, I've been out scouting and glassing the past few days, and I've seen sign of what I think are some really big bulls. Let me first tell you a few things about what marks elk leave behind when they pass through. Let's take a look at these signs. Elk often rub their antlers on saplings. Check out what an elk rub looks like. Find two elk signs, then meet me up at the edge of these woods.
Look for animal signs.
I scouted some turkeys around here and we've got tags. Want to take a break from tackling elk and bag a gobbler? There's a nice tom, but he's probably out of range. I set up a ground blind near that dead tree. If you can sneak over to it, I'll call in those turkeys for you. Those elk. Round here we use tree stands for elk hunting. Look for a good tree in a group nearby, mount your stand, and then call in an elk. Simple, huh? You can only mount a tree stand in special trees. Look for trees with moss and fungus on them.
You can mount your tree stand in the tree nearby.
Company. Use your elk call to bring him into range.
Earlier, I scouted a spot where mule deer go to drink. It's the right time of day, so get moving. Later.
Just up the path is a clearing where a muley herd likes to graze. Hunt one and then head down to the lake. Some nice trophies gather there to drink. Remember, you can find them by using your GPS. Stalk in close to find a spot to take your shot. Make sure you only shoot the big buck. He's the one you want. Some other spots for mule deer and elk. I sent the waypoints to your GPS. Need me to shoot them for you as well? scouted two mule deer bucks foraging for food in a blackberry patch. Find the patch and you'll be in a perfect hunting spot. At the edge of the patch, mount your tree stand and then use your rattling antlers to lure them in. Your tree stand in the tree nearby. That tree can be used to mount your tree stand. Find another tree for a stand and use that call again. That tree can be used to mount your tree stand. That tree can be used to map. I spotted some interesting elk bulls grazing nearby. Find two elk marks in the clearing up ahead to make sure you're in the right spot, and then mount your tree stand on the edge of the clearing. Stand in the tree nearby. Him and bagged him. Nice work, buddy. Now let's head out onto the water. Idaho's got some great fishing waiting for you. Idaho also has excellent fishing for smallmouth bass. Head out onto the water and try to fill up your live well. You need to catch your weight limit of smallmouth and bring it back to the dock before the timer runs out.
Welcome. Welcome. Hook it.
Catch and release. Not the right species.
Hook 'em.
Make it back to the dock with your catch in time. Back to the dock with your catch. You made it in. That was some great fishing out there. Northern Idaho has an awesome reputation for rainbow trout, and you're about to find out why. You need to catch a record trout and bring it back to the dock before your time expires.
Set the hook.
Too small. Try to catch another one.
Hook 'em.
Not heavy enough. Try again.
Set the hook. Thank you. Throw them back. Need a different species. Hook 'em. Catch and release. Not the right species. Time's running out. Set the hook.
Idaho has an awesome reputation for rainbow trout, and you're about to find out why. You need to catch a record trout and bring it back to the dock before your time expires. Hook 'em.
Not heavy enough. Try again.
Hook 'em. Make it back to the dock with your catch in time. Back to the dock with your catch in time.
Move away from the buoy.
Make it back to the dock with your catch in time. Nice catch there, buddy.
Use your duck call to start bringing in blue-winged teal and shoot 10 of them with your shotgun before time expires. Good luck! head on to the next spot. Yesterday, I glassed a really nice billy up in these cliffs. Look for him up high, and start to plan your shot when you see him come into range. Plan your shot carefully. Bad fall onto the rocks below these cliffs will crack a horn and ruin your trophy. Try to shoot him over a spot where he can fall down without hitting any rocks. Spotted a group of mountain goats winding up through some rocky paths over on the other side of the ridge. Find these winding paths, look for a higher shooting position, and bag another nice billy. I told you about. Move atop the cliffs and find a shooting position. I've got a feeling these goats will be moving back through here any minute. The tree nearby looks perfect for a tree stand. time for Idaho's ultimate challenge. I've been tracking a very large elk bull to this bedding place and marked it as a waypoint on your GPS. This fella's a real world-class monster. You've got some tough hunting ahead of you. Good luck. Spotted that trophy elk bull with his harem. Move into position on the top edge of the ridge ahead of you. I'll drive him your way. Be ready. This'll be a tough shot for this bull. Shot. I glassed our herd as it moved on to what I know is private property. Find where they jumped the fence while I get the property owner's permission to hunt on his land. Good news, buddy. The property owner will allow us to hunt his land for that trophy bull. But he insists that you use a handgun and not a rifle. Signs. watched the whole hunt through my binoculars. That was some pretty cool shooting on your part. Let's move up out of Idaho and into the next region. I've got some sweet hunts lined up for you.